the Man of Steel.
Watch out, Superman, Wonder Woman, and Batman 2. Time to step aside. The new superheroes are in town. Meet Super Anthony, Super Remedy, Super Mikey, and there are thousands more like them. Young children across America outfitted with superhero capes as they battle the forces of disease. The force behind this league is Robin Rosenberger, owner of Tiny Superheroes in Seattle. Last year, she made a few capes for fun, and then she sent one to a girl with a severe skin condition. Then a few other sick kids, too. And now, the closet cape is full with requests pouring in from almost everywhere. 1,700 kids around the country wear these capes branded with their first initial for the whole world to see. Robin quit her job as a software manager to keep up with the demand.
It's quite life-changing to, first of all, know how many kids are out there that are dealing with something quite extreme. And then it's also just been life-changing to see how a pretty simple piece of fabric can really change the perspective on what's going on.
That piece of simple fabric is important to seven-year-olds like one-of-a-kind Super Cameron.
Super Cameron is amazing. I love him.
He was adopted a few days after his birth. And then at age two, doctors diagnosed him with restrictive cardiomyopathy, a fatal heart condition. Without a heart transplant, soon he'll die.
The issue is that they go into sudden cardiac death. So it's something where you have no warning. It just all of a sudden the heart stops.
He is now first on the transplant list, and that means carrying a pager at all times, ready and hopeful that it will bring good news.
Why is it going to beep?
Because they might have a heart.
Cameron is no doubt deserving of his superhero cape. One time during a three-day hospital stay, doctors took 16 tubes of blood, but Cameron was concerned with normal kid stuff.
Every time the doctor comes in, I ask her, can I have a bicycle? Can I have a bicycle?
Those times in the hospital did make him think of what he wants to be when he grows up.
I want to be a doctor.
Why do you want to be a doctor?
Because I want to help other kids to be healthy.
Maybe helping others will come soon for Super Cameron, but right now he just can't do normal kid stuff, and that's why his cape is so important to him.
It helps with his confidence. Like when he's outside playing with his friends and they want to like go play ball, he's like, hey, let's play superheroes and I got a cape and so we can do this and that. Mm-hmm. And it kind of keeps things localized and it keeps things at his level and gives him some control over his life.
Cameron's family knows that ultimately God is in control of it all.
If we didn't believe that God was going to take us through this, then I don't know how we'd do it.
Cameron's mom set up a Facebook page called Psalm 147:3. The verse in the Bible about how God heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
It just seemed so fitting because Cameron's heart is broken and he's going to have to get a lot of wounds in order to fix his heart. So that verse just really spoke to me.
And as Cameron prayerfully waits for his new heart, he plays with his sidekick brother, Spencer, and he reads up on his Bible.
I got a huge Bible.
You got a huge Bible.
Yeah.
In the meantime, Cameron is busy raising some money for those hefty medical bills. $5 a piece for a Cameron's Hope bracelet.
Here you are, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The beauty behind the Tiny Superheroes effort is that this is not just about sewing capes. It's about self-esteem, empowerment, and working together with families to raise cash, awareness, and hopefully medical help for the kids.
These kids aren't sad and feeling sorry for themselves or weak in any way. They are more joyful and more strong and more brave than I ever was at their age with no health problems.
And now they've got their superhero cape ready to conquer the battles ahead. David Brody, CBN News in Seattle, Washington.